Well, already here tonight on SmackDown.
How do you think Lin-Manuel enjoys tippy time?
Probably looks like the rest of us, let's be honest.
The following is a women's Money in the Bank qualifying match. Introducing from Briar Lake, Minnesota, Tiffany Stratton.
Tiffany Stratton in recent weeks has attempted to align herself with the irresistible force and queen of the ring, Nia Jax. But Wade, a lot of the WWE Universe are picking Tiffany Stratton not only in this qualifying match, but to win Money in the Bank as a whole. What are your thoughts?
For many people, this is the single greatest athlete in WWE history. A lot of people can make that claim, men and women. This is a former Olympic level gymnast, a former teammate of the great Simone Biles, and she has adapted to the world of WWE like a duck to water. And believe me, this may well be already the odds-on favorite to qualify tonight and ultimately win the Money in the Bank contract.
From Riverside, California, Candice, LeRae!
Well, Friday Night SmackDown is sponsored in part by Call of Duty Mobile. Download Call of Duty Mobile for free and get limited time rewards. Wade, Candice LeRae, a superstar who's been scratching and clawing for an opportunity for a long time here in WWE. We talk about the possibility of Money in the Bank changing a superstar's career. How true is that for someone like Candice LeRae, who hasn't necessarily had the success she sought?
Yeah, Candice LeRae's been very unhappy in recent months, with complete lack of progress for what she would expect of herself career-wise. She's a veteran, she's won a lot of championships, including in NXT, and tonight could be the night that she sets her pathway to the very top.
A storm is coming.
Some would even say, Wade, make or break for Jade Cargill. This is the world's most famous arena. Thus far, Cargill has absolutely lived up to the hype. But what you do here in Madison Square Garden can live on forever. How do you see Jade faring tonight, Wade?
Yeah, I'm excited to see how Jade reacts today. This is really the first glimpse of Jade we've had since Clash at the Castle, where her and Belair lost the Women's Tag Championship to Fire and Dawn. Of course, they were not pinned. They're insisting they want a rematch in the not-too-distant future. We'll see if that happens. However, Corey, this is really the first piece of adversity that Jade Cargill has come across in her time here on SmackDown, and it's a real bounce-back opportunity in the biggest way possible.
Wade, is it a possibility that Jade Cargill is still too focused on the WWE Women's Tag Team Championship, focused on the fact that she came up short on a premium live event, or do you think Cargill has compartmentalized to move on?
Yeah, it can really hurt a superstar's career, especially when they haven't had a lot of reps here, like Cargill, but she is out of the blocks hot. Nice start.
Sometimes raw power is a hell of a substitute for experience, as Cargill has shown on multiple occasions. Ooh, you gotta give the experience advantage in this matchup to Candice LeRae, a world-traveled grappler. Little teamwork.
I mean, let's be honest, physically, Candice LeRae is just no match for Stratton and Cargill, two tremendous athletes. Not that Candice LeRae is not a superb athlete in her own right, but she has to be smart and crafty to win this one.
I like this strategy off the opening bell by Stratton and LeRae, joining forces to take out the powerhouse Cargill.
Yeah, it's the smartest thing you can do here. Clearly, Cargill, a massive threat. Anytime that bell rings, take her out early and turn this into a one-on-one matchup.
This Women's Money in the Bank qualifying matchup obviously being contested under triple threat rules. The only way to win is by pinfall or submission, no count out, no disqualification. And right now, Candice LeRae is caught in the power of the storm.
No matter what you throw at this woman, she seems to find an answer.
And when wow!
When you have the physical gift that Jade Cargill does, it just sometimes seems so easy.
Let's take another look at the super kick that may have just kicked Tiffany's bicuspid to the Bronx. Look at this power, bad news! LeRae tossed to the outside, taking out Stratton. Jade Cargill is ruling the roost. Wait a minute. The irresistible force, Queen Nia Jax, has hit the scene. But why? Wait,
but why?